So, dear students, yesterday we have started a new chapter which is the file handling in Python. And let us a quick review whatever we have discussed yesterday class. So, first of all, file is the collection of records. The collection of records and related informations are stored under a single name, which is known as file. Secondly, files are broadly classified into two parts. The first is text file and the second is binary file. Text file is a kind of file which contains the textual information. Textual information means whatever you can see on your keyboard. These all are considered as a text. For example, alphabets, digits, special characters, symbols, the collection of all these things is called text. So the text file contains the textual information. It also contains a special type of marker or a special type of character which is called the EOL, abbreviation of end of line character, which indicates that the line is terminated and the new line is started. Thirdly, it also contains another special type of marker or a special type of character which is known as EOF, which is the acronym of end of file. End of file means the file is the end of file point is reached, means all the contents have been read or write. So these two types of special markers are used in textual information. Secondly, as far as the binary files are concerned, binary files are the compiled version of text file. It can stores the information in the form. It can stores the information in the same form in which computer can hold the information. That is the sequence of bytes or sequence of bits. As we know that computer stores the information in the sequence of bits, bytes. Similarly, in binary file, the informations are arranged in a sequence of bit or byte, sometimes 8-bit, sometimes 16-bit sequence. These are the binary files. Again, the second most important point about the binary file is that the binary file can only be accessed through the programs. On the contrary, if a text file can be opened by just using the double click after giving the desired location where the file is stored, and we can see the contents of a text file, but in the case of binary file, if we want to see the contents of a binary file, then these contents can only be shown by using the programs. So these contents cannot be directly retrieved in your monitor. And thirdly, it can contain many types of information, such as it can contain image, it can contain text, it can contain graphics, audio, etc., etc. So these are the difference of binary file and text file. Thirdly, we have discussed about the file in reference to opening a file. Whatever operation is performed on a file, basically two types of operations are performed in a file. I am not giving in details because details are also discussed in the last class, why files are used, what is the concept of file, etc., etc. But briefly, if we discuss about the file in brief, that if we want to do any kind of operation such as read operation or write operation on a file, on a text file, on a binary file, then we have to first open that file. And to open a file, we use a built-in member function which is called the open member function. This open member function contains two parameters, the name of the file, which is a null terminated character string, denote the name of a file, and the opening mode. Opening modes can represent that in which type of mode file is going to be opened, or in other words, we can also say that what type of operation, either the read operation or write operation, etc., what type of operation can be what type of operation is going to be performed on that specific file stream. So two parameters are used in the open member function. First of all, file name, and second, opening mode. Third, very important, that a special kind of file pointer, also known as file handle, also known as file object, is used to perform any kind of or various kinds of operations on a file. File pointer, file handle, and or file object, any name can be used because these all names are delivered the same meaning. So to open a file, we have discussed about the syntax and then example. Now let us know how many types of opening modes are there to open a file. So opening modes. Opening modes. So first of all, R to read a file. Read a file. This is the default mode. If we do not use any kind of opening mode, then file will be automatically opened in the read mode. Secondly, write. W represents that to write a file. Write a file. Third is X means exclusive creation. Exclusive creation. Fourth is A. That means append mode. Append mode. Here adding in append mode, that append mode is only applicable for the write operation. Number one, always remember that append mode is only applicable for the write operation, and the write operation will be performed at the last of the file. That means the new contents will be added by containing the old contents of the file. Then T means text mode. Text mode. B means binary mode. Binary mode. And plus opens a file for updating. Opens a file for dating, means if we want to open a file in more than one mode, then two mode or three mode, then all these modes are concatenated by using this operator, plus operator. So these are the opening modes. For example, we open a file in read and binary mode. So we write, first of all, file handle. Suppose file handle or file object is my file. File handle should be a valid identifier. Also remember, my file is equal to open file name. Suppose file name is example.txt. Dot text, and then opening mode R plus B. This. Now, again, take a example. My file is equal to open. My file, there are no spaces allowed in declaring the file handle. So open example dot text, and now this time we are opening a file with append mode. Means we are going to perform write operation. If file is open in append mode, then you cannot perform the read operation on the file, because append mode is only applicable for the write operation, because the write operation will be performed at the end of the file. Means after the write operation, old and new contents both will be added in the text file. So these are the opening modes. Last but not the least, that if file does not exist in your secondary storage media such as hard disk or any other secondary memory, then file does not exist error will be displayed on your monitor. If file is not existing in your computer system, then an error will be shown in your monitor. So this is all about the opening mode. Opening mode. Now after performing any kind of operations on your file, your duty is to close the file, because it is the good skill of any programmer that if he opens a file and he performs various kinds of operations on file, then always at last he must close the file. And to close a file, another built-in function close with no argument is used. So close